Hey folks, how's it going? My name is Dustin Smith and I'm with A2K, Allegiance to the King. And today we're going to begin a new series on our YouTube called Responsibly Reading Revelation, meaning learning how to responsibly read the book of Revelation, the last book of our New Testament. There's a lot of confusion out there regarding how we're supposed to read this book or whether we're supposed to be reading it even in the first place. There are some people that think that it's all having to do with the first century, and thereby it has no relevance for us today. There's some other people on an extreme that think that it has everything to do with the future, and it has no relevance for us today. Well, folks, I think both are right and both are wrong, okay? Because certainly the book of Revelation was written to seven historical churches, and certainly the book has its final revealing of the new heavens and the new earth, and the ultimate consummation of the kingdom of God when Jesus returns. But the book is still sacred scripture, and one of the things that I want to get across to our listeners on YouTube is that the book of Revelation is something that you can apply to your life today. It's something you could use in Christian discipleship today, right now, this very instance, okay? And I'm going to encourage you to be faithful in allegiance to the King in following what the book of Revelation says in regard to our life, okay? So to do this, I want to look at a particular word and do a word study today on how we can apply these things to our life, okay? So very quick study. We're going to start in Revelation chapter 1 and verse 3, where it says, "Blessed is he who reads and those who hear the words of the prophecy," and here's our key word, "heeds the things that are written in it, for the time is near." Okay, did you catch that? It actually says that we will be blessed if we do three things. If we read the things that are in it, if we listen to the things that are in it, and if we heed the things that are written in it. Okay, and I want to focus on that last word, that word heed, that verb heed. It comes from the Greek verb tereo, which means to heed, to observe, to hold, or to maintain, okay? So we're actually told in this book, in Revelation 1:3, that we will be blessed if we observe and if we maintain the things that are written in this book. Now, for a lot of people, their particular view on Revelation doesn't take into account how the book of Revelation and the things that are written in it are supposed to be maintained and observed by Christians. Usually they're things that are just kind of interpreted in history on one extreme, or they're to be decoded through the right lens through which you read the book of Revelation by those people who view it as strictly in the future. But Revelation tells us that we are to heed, to observe, and to maintain the things that are in it, and there's a promise that we will be blessed if we do so. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is we're going to do a brief word study on this Greek verb tereo, and we're going to look at every single time that the book tells us that we are supposed to be heeding, keeping, maintaining, and observing the things that are written in it. Okay, so we're going to see how we can apply this to our lives as we responsibly read Revelation. Okay, so we already saw Revelation 1:3, where the verb gets introduced, and now we're going to look at Revelation 2 and verse 26. Where Jesus says, "He who overcomes and he who keeps my deeds until the end, to him I will give authority over the nations." That's Revelation 2:26. And Jesus says that the one who overcomes, the one who conquers, and he who keeps, there's our verb, he who keeps my deeds until the end, they're going to receive authority over the nations. They're going to receive authority in the future kingdom of God. But to do that, we need to overcome, and we need to keep Jesus' deeds until the end. Jesus teaches us that there are certain things we're supposed to be doing and observing within the book of Revelation, and we are told that if we keep those things, if we maintain them, we will receive this appropriate reward. Okay? Revelation chapter 3 and verse 3 has Jesus speaking to the church in Sardis, and he says, "So remember what you have received and heard," and here's our verb, "keep it and repent." All right, so Jesus reminds this church that they need to think about what they have received and heard, likely the original gospel message and the commission to be faithful preachers and evangelists of that gospel message, and they're to keep it and they're to repent. So guess what? We also are supposed to keep it and repent, okay? So there's a way that we can keep the things that are written in this book. Chapter 3 and verse 8 is our next passage. Jesus tells the church in Philadelphia, "I know your deeds. Behold, I have put before you an open door which no one can shut, because you have a little power and have kept, there's our verb, you have kept my word and you've not denied my name. Okay. Jesus acknowledges and praises this church because they have kept, they have maintained, they have observed Jesus' word, meaning they have kept Jesus' gospel message about the kingdom. That's what the word means in this passage. It means a reference to the gospel message. They have maintained Jesus' gospel and they have not denied his name, meaning everything that Jesus stands for within his ministry and his faithful life, death, and resurrection. Okay? Verse 10 in chapter 3 continues this theme. Because you have kept my word of my perseverance, I will also keep you from the hour of testing. Okay? So Jesus, again, praises them for keeping this message, this word, this command about perseverance. And Jesus will also keep them from a time of testing. Okay? So that sounds like a good thing, that we need to also be maintaining Jesus' teaching about perseverance, about steadfastness, about nonviolent resistance. That's basically what the word means. We can move ahead to chapter 12 and verse 17, and we can see another important passage. It's actually one of my favorite ones in this book. Chapter 12, 17 says, "So the dragon was enraged with the woman and went off to make war with the rest of her children who keep the commandments of God and hold to the testimony of Jesus." So here we have this reference to the children of this woman, and the dragon, the devil, is going to attack and make war with them. And these people are the ones who are defined as those who do two things. They keep the commandments of God, and they hold to the testimony of Jesus, meaning they hold to the gospel message about Jesus and that Jesus himself preached, meaning Jesus' gospel message about the kingdom of God. But these people are the ones who keep the commandments of God. So as I read this, I think I also need to be keeping the commandments of God. That will truly identify me as a child of this woman. And I need to be holding and maintaining the testimony that Jesus himself preached, meaning the gospel message about the kingdom of God. Next one is in chapter 14 and verse 12. "Here is the perseverance of the saints who keep," there's our verb, "keep the commandments of God and the faithfulness of Jesus." All right? So very similar to the previous passage we looked at, the saints are described as those who are demonstrating perseverance, demonstrating steadfastness by keeping the commandments of God and the faithfulness of Jesus. Okay? Jesus was faithful in preaching the gospel. He was faithful in not compromising in his mission, and he was faithful in being allegiant to the plans that God had for him, even when it led to his martyrdom. Okay? Chapter 16 and verse 15 says, "Behold, I'm coming like a thief. Blessed is the one who stays awake and keeps his clothes, so that he will not walk about naked and men will not see his shame." Okay, so here there's another blessing that's promised to those who stay awake. They're not deluded by compromising with a fallen world, and they keep their clothes. Now, the imagery of keeping one's clothes appears in some of the earlier chapters, chapters 2 and 3, but it also gets explained for us in chapter 19, where it says that the clothes are the righteous acts of the saints, okay? So by keeping our clothes, that means that we continue to demonstrate and observe the righteous acts that we are taught within this book, okay? And we are told that we are blessed if we do so. Last two passages are in chapter 22, chapter 22, starting in verse 7. Where Jesus says, "Behold, I am coming quickly. Blessed is he who heeds the words of the prophecy in this book." Again, I'm told that I'm blessed if I heed, if I maintain, and if I observe the things, particularly the prophecy that's written in this book. And then in chapter 22 and verse 9, there's an angel that said to John, "Do not do that. I am a fellow servant of yours and of the brethren, the prophets, and of those who heed," there's our verb, "who heed the words of this book." Okay? So again, we're supposed to heed, maintain, observe, and obey the words that are written within the book of Revelation. Okay? So as you can see, this promise that we saw back in chapter 1 and verse 3, that we are blessed if we read them, if we listen to them, and if we heed the things that are written in this book, that's a promise that we can read throughout this book, starting from chapter 1, going all the way through, even to the end in chapter 22, and we can apply these things to our life. We could use them in our walk with Christ, and we could use them to be allegiant to the King. So hopefully this has encouraged you to read the book of Revelation more responsibly, and stay tuned for more updates on this really exciting series as we unpack and we teach how to be faithful followers of Christ by reading this particular book and applying it to our lives. My name is Dustin Smith. I'm with A2K, Allegiance to the King. And until next time, take care.